The next question I have received from the sister: my husband touched me and I'm keep taking a pain. What should I do? Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. It's really simple, because Islam gives equal rights for the woman and for the man together. Nobody can abuse no one, nobody can torture no one, except stay in the limits and try to give the respect and love and care for your partner, whether it's a husband, it's a woman, whoever it is, but they are both obligated by Allah to be peaceful for each other, and you have to love and care about each other. And so Islam gives an equality, equal rights to both of them. So a husband does not have the right to be abusive to the wife, and also the wife does not have the right to abuse her husband. Rather, the root cause of that is something what is an anger, and something like a verbal abusing. And then some husbands, and they come and they go more further into the getting a physical abuse to the woman. Now I'm receiving like many cases about that. It's very simple as that. If your husband is not being coming in control and they continue to do that, so a woman has a free option, so she can file a full-up with the local council and try to reach out with the local scholar and try to get out of it Islamically, or go back to your family, whatever you want. So Islam gives you a full 100% right. Either you can take the pain, or you can get beat up every day, or you can get verbal abuses every day, or you can free yourself. It's because Islam does not take. Also, you have to understand, sorry. In one of the hadith of the Allah said, Allah has forbidden a zulm on himself, and also Allah has forbidden a zulm even on our own self. We are not even allowed to do the zulm on our own body, and because the body and everything belongs to Allah, it does not belong to us. So we have to do according to what Allah says. And if your husband is abusing, or the wife is abusing to the husband, and they both have the right to get separate, to get the divorce Islamically, and they can contact a local government law. And also, if somebody is living in an Islamic country, they can definitely contact their local Sharia council and contact the police or whatever you want if somebody is getting over abusing to you. So the woman has a 100% right to get a file of khula, and the khula application is something like you file the divorce against the husband when the abuse is like an over limit, like physical abuses and torturing, and she is not living in a peaceful, so she totally has a right to get out from that type of relationship. Because many men and many women are also like has a short temper and a mental illness, and they could not control their temper, they could not control their mind, so they start abusing their own partner. So rather try to find your way out, rather than destroying yourself and keep suffering a wound from your partner. So I would definitely say that if it is getting over limits, or rather you can get it out by filing a khula with the local Sharia council. If you're living in an Islamic country, you can file with the court. If you're living in a non-Islamic country, you can have to contact your local Sharia council to file the khula for you, and they're going to contact the husband. If he's cooperative, that means right to settle down. If not, so they're going to issue a declaration of a khula. It's like a divorce for the woman.